If you have a Wolverine HPA and it has some issues such as air leaking and inconsistent FPS, then you come to the right place. I would like to start from one assumption that you have already used good quality BBs and everything else such as chamber, bucking and inner barrel are in good conditions. Before I continue, write down your HPA issue in the comment section and don't forget to give a like or dislike to this video. And you can subscribe if you want to follow this channel. The first thing that I need to do is obvious, which is to remove the engine out from the gearbox. And in order to do that, I need to remove the gearbox out from the receiver. I need to remove all of the screws from the receiver. Because I'm using a Crytek gearbox, I need to remove the ambidex selector. Be careful with all of the screws. And again, because I'm using a Crytek gearbox, I need to remove a small component that holds the functional bolt catch. And also there is a small gear for the ambidex selector that has a screw. I need to remove that screw in order to take the gearbox apart. And in order to make this process comfortable, I suggest you to prepare a magnet or a motor that you don't use in order to stick the screws. I need to pay attention to every small detail in this gearbox in order to remove it. If you have another brand for the gearbox, maybe you will have some different features. And it could be easier. So I can remove the gearbox. Now I have the access to the engine. Make sure to keep all of the screws. In order to take the engine out, I need to remove the wire that connects to the solenoid. And now I have the engine, I'm going to disassemble it. The first, I'm going to turn this out. Inside there's the nozzle and this cylinder part. As you can see, there are four O-rings here. So I'm going to use a grease to loop them all. This is the first one near the nozzle. This is the easiest one because you can just take it out easily. Make sure that you remember the place for every O-ring that you take out. Loop this O-ring and put it back. Make sure that you loop to this spot. And now it's done. Next, I'm going to find the second O-ring and loop it. This is the one on the cylinder. It is a bit tricky to take it off. I use my nails to take the O-ring out. Okay, now it's done. I'm going to loop it and I will put it back just the same like the initial position. Make sure that you do this. This is the third O-ring. I'll choose the bigger size first. I need to remove this O-ring. I'll use my nail. This one is easier. Now I will do the same process again. If you find your O-ring damaged, you need to replace it with the new one. Otherwise, you can just loop it, just like I did. And next, after put the third O-ring back to its initial position, I'm going to remove the fourth O-ring. It is very tricky to take this out. Make sure that you don't damage the O-ring when you take it out. Do the same process, apply the grease and put it back together again. Now it's time to assemble the engine back. Do you still remember how to assemble it? First with the spring, next with the cylinder. Third one is the nozzle. Make sure you also put the O-ring, the one that's on the nozzle, if it falls. And next, I'm going to put the final part back. Hold the nozzle and put the final part and screw it back just like the original position. If you do this for the first time, it may be very tricky, but I'm sure you will get it. Okay, the second thing that you need to check is the regulator. Make sure that you remove the three screws on your regulator. And you can see there are some components too that have O-rings. Remove it like this. You can see O-ring. Then you need to lube it. For this part, it's a bit tricky. You can use scissors. Just like I did, in order to remove the final part. Be careful that there is a small ball bearing in this final part that it may roll to any place, so make sure that you keep it. Okay, this is the final part. As you can see, there's a small ball bearing right there. Put it somewhere safe. And next, we'll do the same process, which is to loop every O-ring that we can see. This is the first one. It's a bit easier to take it off. Okay, take out the O-ring and loop it. Put it back again like the initial position. Next, this small O-ring, the one that on the ball bearings holder. You can actually put the ball bearing down first if you want. Make sure that you loop this small O-ring. I'll skip that part. Next is this, the one on the component that looks like nozzle. Also loop this O-ring and put it back to the initial position. After you loop all of the O-rings, next put the ball bearing back. Put everything back together again. Make sure that you do it in right sequence. Put the spring back, this component, and the final part. Make sure that you screw these three components back together again. Now you just loop your engine and your regulator. This is actually the basic maintenance that you can do to your HPA. Now put everything back together again and now put it into a test. Before putting back the engine to the gearbox and the gearbox to the receiver, you can test for the engine first before putting it inside the gearbox. If it operates normally, then you can put it inside the gearbox. As you can see, there is no more leaking. I didn't do the chrono before I fixed this HPA, but as I remember, it was shooting at 360, it dropped to 330, and it dropped to 320 because the muzzle was so sticky. Okay guys, I think that's all for today's video. If you find this video is useful, you can share it to your friends, and thank you for watching.